Here's Claudio. Now, I think kind of the first thing I wanted to ask you really was Italy basically just seems to be constantly a house nation. It seems to love kind of very particular kind of house music. Why is that? And is that really the case?
I need that you speak so slowly. A little bit slowly because
I'll slow it right down.
So quickly that I understand half and half. Mm-hmm.
The basic question.
Because I want to, for first, my English is very elemental. Okay? And then I need to use my arm, Italian style, you know? But I think it's good for, because you are in Italy, you must learn the Italian attitude, okay? I think for be patient to understand what I mean, okay.
Okay. Sì.
There's a lot of different reasons. The mains are, Italy was like other country, not the main land where house music, electronic music is born, but was like a colony, you know, of Anglo-Saxon, London, New York. I've been young every time in my life I see to London, to New York, like the place where the things are doing. Mm-hmm. And that's it. It's true until 90s. That is true because it's a historical truth that house music is born in USA. Now the scene is completely different. Mm-hmm. House music is by the world. Mm-hmm. The scene is completely changing. I think that house music was not a musical gender, but a musical attitude. It's a mood that you can use to be DJ, that you can use to be a person that use material sound stuff different from rock, from electronic, from everything. In a mood that is house. House is just the way. But house music is no national, like I speak about the culture, no nation, no sex, no race, no class. Mm-hmm. And this is the main for me. Mm-hmm. I think that in Italy it's been so popular and appreciated because in Italy the club scene is very important in the social context. Mm-hmm. It's not simply a place where dance, but it's a really and a weekly appointment for everybody. Mm-hmm. Go to the club, meet every other person, listen music, dance, live in the music. Mm-hmm. It's the only possibility. Mm-hmm. young Italians have.
There seems to be something very interesting about the way that clubs physically have developed in Italy, you know, that you have so many clubs which are basically events in themselves, very, very big clubs, very ornate, kind of a whole load of architecture stuff going on. How did that happen?
See, it's very difficult to explain. We start to copy, okay? Like, I think, every other country in the world, no? We are start to copy the London scene, the clubs by London, like, I don't know, until a few years ago, Minister of Sound was very, very famous in Italy. I saw with my eyes people with a tattoo of the logo Minister of Sound.
This is our Italians with a Ministry of Sound tattoo.
Yeah, because I think that that's a great power of the English scene over the world, that is the marketing power, the power of the press, of the weapons that English are to marketing its product. We are, in first time, victim about, because everything from London was brilliant, was perfect, was the best. Now it's completely changed, because the relation is on the same place, you know? We think in Italy that there's a good sensibility, a good level of professionality to do a good club that is not only a club that make money and nothing else, but make culture as some money. This is the balance. There's no good club if that's only market view. I think so. We try to do this in Rome with my club is Goa at Rome, and we do a program, a plan that is okay, a marketing plan, but with a view to our soul, our visual to the musical contest. We need to it's like a little mission, you know. We need to explain to our customs and the people that follow us that the club is a place where the culture involved, mm-hmm. not the place where you pay for the ticket and nothing else.
I mean, you were saying to me a minute ago that kind of your philosophy was that it's not about being a superstar DJ, it's about the music.
Yeah.
How do you do that with Goa? How does that come across in the kind of DJs you book or the kind of music you play at the club?
This is another problematic answer, because I think that I speak about me in person. I don't ask never in my life to be a superstar DJ. That's the everything is happening out of me, out of my intention. I do just my job, play music, play records, nothing else. Somebody comes to say, you're the one, you're the best. Cover on the press, I don't know, records, Ibiza, something else. But it's not the goal of my life. The goal of my life is every night that I play, do it better. Better than the night before.
So say this season at Goa, I presume you were playing there fairly regularly.
Sorry?
So this summer, so for example, okay. When you're DJing,
yeah.
What particular kind of music or records were very big for you?
I don't think that is a particular kind of music. I try to feel the music like ever I done in my life. When I was a child, I don't see what is rock or what is pop or what is folk. I with a come si dice ingenuità. Okay, sorry. With a simply way, okay. I do my choice with the skin. I listen something. I say, this is good. This is good. But I try to say this now, mm-hmm. that I'm 40, because it's very different, but it's very possible to be conditioned by media, mm-hmm. Scene, marketing, mm-hmm. and I don't want that. I play what I feel really good.
And specifically, what kind of things have you been playing?
Oh, okay. Specifically, I think is dance music, electronic, modern, with a lot of reference to the past or to the future, but it is not so important, because I think that house music is a spherical thing. Without you can see in a lot of different sides, but you see even the sphere. Huh? But every phase is different. I think that house music is a box where you can put inside everything, from electro to techno to soul to disco. I love to mix every elements and say, okay, that in this record from I don't know, from Berlin or from New York, I heard something is a sensation, it's not a sound element, is not a particular kind of music or particular structure.
I mean, I noticed on your chart, on your website, you had Chuk Chuk Chuk, Alter Ego, The Orb, and Hakan Libdo, I think were the top four tunes.
Yeah, you speak about my chart. Mm-hmm. And,
I mean, is that representative? Say if we were going to come and see you at Goa tonight, is that what we'd be hearing you play?
Yeah. At the moment, it's the music that give me emotion. Because when I listen Chiki Chiki Chik, I think it's something that built a chain with a talking heads 20 years ago. And now that's a sound from USA that's very interesting thing, because it correlates funk, disco, and electronic in just one thing. It's very similar to me, because I need to express myself in different way. I'm not so happy to recognize that the people recognize in me an house DJ, because house is for the masses is a restrictive, yes? Un concetto restrittivo? So small, okay. Also, it's exactly a small concept. Perfect. Thank you.
It's a bit limited.
Then I need to chicka chick chick give me the occasion to play something from the past that is very different, that is very difficult to play in an electronic set straight. That's a lot of things that give me the occasion to do a diversion in my set.
I mean, I wanted to
go
ask you
around.
I mean, I wanted to ask you about the American connection, because there's some interesting things there. But before that, you're kind of talking about Chuk Chuk Chuk. But it kind of, you know, in your position as kind of like the biggest DJ in Italy, do you ever find it difficult to play the things that you want? Kind of, are you limited in any way by the kind of the fact that so many people want to come and see you?
In relation with the group.
Yeah, I suppose, is your status as kind of the top DJ, does that have limitations to what you can play?
Cioè, se io... No, I think and I hope to be not influenced by my position. I try to use my position to do something special, do something different, because I think it's a duty for a DJ that have a name, do something special, do different. If you try to keep the applause with a hit, with a so simple records, for me the challenge is lost, because it is loose, because the challenge for the DJ, it is my opinion, is try to dance to the people, to the crowd in the dance floor, what the crowd don't think is possible dance. This is a real challenge for me.
Well, let's talk about a little bit of the first times, the late 80s, when Italy, in addition to be a place where electronic music was widely appreciated, became a major production center in electronic music. So could you please tell us a little bit about those times and how Italians started actually producing good electronic music, and massively, when you heard people like Black Box and all those stuff. Beh, nei primi giorni, parliamoci un po' dei primi giorni, perché l'Italia, soprattutto alla fine degli anni Ottanta, era un paese dove non si apprezzava la musica elettronica, però è cominciato, perlomeno per noi stranieri, così all'improvviso ad essere un centro di produzione massiva e molto buona di musica elettronica. Puoi parlarci un po' di quei giorni? Quando spero che essere di DJ era proprio una sfida.
Ok.
Io credo che... Bravo, grazie.
Prego.
Per l'italiano perfetto.
Sono del Brasile.
No, non so se risponderti in italiano o in inglese a questo punto. Perché your Italian is better than my English, huh? But everything is right, but not so right, because Italy of the 80s was a really adventure land, you know. That's a lot, so few people that do electronics production. With a pioneer attitude, okay.
Who would you say these pioneers are?
Sorry.
You said. Who are you talking about specifically?
For sure, Black Box, but I remember about stuff like Keno, that is remixed in these days by Santiago. Keno, I'm ready, that was in Rome. Maybe I have some, but I don't know. But I think that you speak about this with Metro Aria, no? I suppose so, because I was so inspired by the 80s of Italian record. No, I have nothing about. No.
I mean, do you have
what I wanna say that in the first time is my roots too. In the 80s, everybody that like me use a 808 or the first sample, we are in a condition that speaking with a serious musician don't do to us any credibility, any. And this has been for maybe 10 years, 15 years. And Black Box and everything that you know so well, because are famous worldwide.
49ers.
Exactly. Was just single experience, not experienced by a scene. There's not a scene. There was not. There was.
It was marked as a scene.
There was persons, okay? Black Box in person, 49ers in person, but without any relation. Because there, Italy, by. I remember that everything that you are named was by two or three little labels, okay? Without no power to the marketing, without just with the power of the ideas, nothing else. And that is not so changed at the moment, because there's no the majors to support the sound of a little producer or the small labels. There's only the auto financial. There's no structure.
I mean, this brings us on very neatly to something I was going to ask you. There was a quote from you in an interview where you said that the music was born as something avant-garde, not as something for business. And obviously, with the kind of acts we're talking about, that there was that kind of sense of experimentation.
Yeah.
Which kind of people are still doing that now in Italy?
I think that everything in Italy started from the 70s, not from the 80s. Because there was a club in near Riccione, named Baia degli Angeli, where there was Mozart and DJ Baldelli that start to play in a different way that never heard before, okay? These guys make it with a great liberty, everything from funk, James Brown, I don't know, to Kraftwerk, to everything should be new, should be different in the club. That is called in Italy Afro. I don't know why, nobody say why. Afro, because that's a lot of percussion moments in their sets, but they're not a reference to the music, you know? It is a nickname, Afro. But there was my roots, because today I'm a DJ, because I listen a tape of Mozart and Baldelli doing in 78 in Baia degli Angeli.
Did you go to the club?
No, never. I received the tapes with the sets, and I listened for a long time the sets to understand what's happening in the tape, what is mixing, what is we speak about 78, probably the first DJ that used the mixer in a creative way. But the nice thing to do, to say for me, and I need to explain, that this is Chicken Lips DJ Kicks. I think that you know this. And with a big surprise of myself, I found inside everything from the Afro of Baldelli, Mozart of 78. Because stuff like, I don't know, probably Nina Hagen, this.
Okay, so what's this tune you're playing?
Yeah, just for and to the story. The sound of Chicken Lips is a perfect fusion from my roots and my future, or actual, the sound that actually I love to play. That's a reason, a historical reason. And this is the mission of DJ, I think. Because it's not so important to produce music by the music, for the music. We are not musician, we are not academic background to do something of high, of a special. But we can relate some elements from the past, from the future, from electronics thing, from breaking glass, from I don't know what, and do something or different, because this is our real in the business. I think it's so, and we need to give pleasure to the people that dance on the dance floor, because it's the first reason to be in this world. And I think that the sound is the perfect mixing is the mixing from the memories and the fantasy. This is the real thing to do.
So the perfect mix is somewhere between memory, something that evokes memory and fantasy.
Exactly.
I think it's kind of this whole thing about Leo Young kind of introducing Chicken Lips to this sound is quite interesting. Is that something you ever did with Basement Jaxx?
Yeah. With Basement Jaxx, we have a relation that starts from the first time. The first time that Basement Jaxx exists, and me too, in an international scene, you know. I meet them for, I don't remember exactly, probably in a party, you know, the worst club of London, I don't know. And they at time are really interested by Brazilian sound contaminated in the electronic music. And I really attracted about this, because it's the same that I try to done in at my own. And exactly after that summer dates come out, that was the first hit of Basement Jaxx, Little Hit. No? I say to Simon and Felix, I do this. Was Belo Horizonte, and I say to them, guys. Nobody wants this track in Italy. Nobody. I go around for every label. Are you interested? Because the sound is very similar. And Faye said to me, of course, but just one thing. The intro is a little bit long. And I say, Felix, please, the intro is perfect. Or you press like this or not, please. Okay. Simon and Felix believe in the track, and Belo Horizonte. I say that in these stories, there's when you do a record, okay, when a person like a DJ, little DJ, little producer do a record, do like a son, you know, it's your records, but in the same time that the records come to make money, this record is not your anymore. Because it's everybody speaks about your production except yourself. It's incredible. And it's a, come si dice, direttamente proporzionale. More is the success, more is out of control.
I mean, I guess you must still be getting royalty checks from that record.
No, because I remember when I speak about Basement Jaxx, that the first time of this record was so romantic, you know. Everybody say to me, "Oh, good, it's okay, great idea, great intention." Then only money. How much copy? Where you are licensed? And which part of the world? But I'm not interested about this, no? But this is the relation with the records. Now, Belo Horizonte is important in my career. I don't think it's so near to me like other things. Because it's like a song that go away from you, you know.
I mean, obviously you're DJing a lot, but how much are you producing now?
I don't understand nothing. Yeah. Oh, sorry.
Si.
I stopped to produce for a while because a few years ago I saw that the scene, the record scene was fall out in a horrible way. And I tried to save the credibility of my little label, the Dub Records, with a sabbatic, you know, sabbatic period of relax, to understand, to recover some energy, some ideas. Now I'm ready. Now I'm ready because I really feel and I really believe that it's not so dramatic like the market, like the major say every day to us. Ah, it's a drama. It's everything is lost. No, I don't think so. I think that if that's so downloads on the web, there's a lot of people that needs music. This is a fact.
I mean, a lot of this might be record label dramatics, but it's got to be a kind of strange time to be a dance music DJ.
Sorry.
I'm so tired.
Tempi strani? Strange? I don't think so. I think that is the right time. Right time because a DJ is have a trust of the people. Come si dice, Fede, scusami, trust in DJ. The people trust in DJ because a DJ is a real operator. It's not a rock star on the stage, far from the people. It's in the people, in the dance floor. Exactly. And I think that if I chose this, I put my face on this, okay? This is not in a musical high scene, you know? If you want to say to Michael Jackson that the last one is a shit, it's impossible. If you want to say to me that I'm mixing like a dog, it's possible. Every time, every day, every night. It's true. That is a relation of with people that give you some success, some popularity, because I think it's thankful. It's thankful by the people that say thanks to do this for us in a right way, okay? Because that's an example of DJing that I don't appreciate, I don't understand, but I'm on the on the border. I'm it's so difficult to explain because, like I said before, I'm famous. It's a great word. Okay, famous is another thing because I remember that a great actor say you are famous when in Bangladesh somebody do your name write your name in the right way. This is famous. Not the DJ famous little thing, but I don't need this. This is only a reflection on my job. It's okay. That's a lot of vintage. That's a lot of funny things, amazing things. But it is not my goal. My goal is have a 2 decks before because are my shield, Scudi. This is my shield, okay? Because I'm not so egocentric. And I need to stay. I need this protection by the people. But in the same time, I need to relate it with the people about my expression that is music. Music for me is put the record in a way. The record is important, Chiquilips is important, my productions can be important, but it's little pieces in a puzzle.
I mean, obviously a lot of people here are DJs, run clubs, play regularly. Are you saying that as far as you're concerned, mixing and how you play the music is the most important skill a DJ has?
Of course, mixing is important because everything from production to other activity or DJ comes from the relation with the crowd. I need to great advantage is in real time understand what the people think, what the people feel. There's no musician can check this in the same time. Because if a musician do a record, must wait 3 months, 4 months for a feedback. We have a feedback in a while. I put the records, I see on face, and I understand if it's good, if not, maybe it's good. This is a background, very important when we come in a studio in relation with the other musicians, because we can tell to the others what's happened in the dance floor.
So from your viewpoint from behind the decks, what does the dance floor want right now?
At the moment, I have maybe nothing from... But I want to speak about something that has happened, but it is no good for me. That's, you know, everybody knows that... Summer it is Soul Central for maybe, but the original track is this. I wanna say that if you wanna play this, play the original, because that 10 years ago, Derek May, I think 10 years, probably.
But maybe what I was asking there was, what other records have you got in there that you think are so good that they shouldn't be remixed?
Sorry, but I have no experience by discussion like Red Bull Academy like this, and I chose something with not a particular order. I want to listen something from Detroit, but 10 years later. This is Moody Man. Somebody knows? Okay. Moody Man is a strange person. I think so. I don't know in person. I don't know, but I imagine that is very... I don't know what. But it's a person that come from the black music, for sure, with a blues attitude, with a deep attitude, that sometime do something like this. And that's okay, but there's something like this, more complex. That is very important for me. This is one of my favorite records. A musician study all the life for put the right notes in the right place, okay? If I producing with my computer and I play, a viola 2 octaves up or down, nobody say to me, what fucking are doing? It's only my taste to say to me it's right. It's a new sound. It's a occasion for the fantasy. I don't think that every musician is like this, but it's very hard to speak with a person that related with the music in a strong way. Okay.
I think music's always been moved on by people using their instruments or their technology incorrectly, by kind of doing things
exactly.
That you wouldn't do if you were trained. You know, you wouldn't turn everything up to 10, or
exactly.
You wouldn't kind of play it in a certain way. But with these kind of records, how often are you playing things like this in your sets at the moment?
In what moment of the sets?
No, like right now when you're playing, how often will you drop one of those classics or this kind
ever.
Of...
Ever in my sets, because my goal, my personal mission is break the barrier, the time barrier. Mm-hmm. I'm really bored about anybody that speaks about promo, last one, because it's a great shame for the, come si dice, la dignità?
Dignity.
A dignity of the DJ. What's the meaning of last one? If every record is should be a piece of art, probably it's a piece of soul of the people that made it, okay? And I use this with a lot of respect. This is the same reason because I use only vinyl. Because, not because CD is as devil, but just because the, come si dice, il sentiero, il... cioè per arrivare a una cosa, il percorso,
the path
to arrive to something with a CD is very simple, so quickly, okay? You you have no respect about the people that made it. You go on the web, you download, in three minutes you can play that track. If you found a vinyl, maybe that's 3 days, sometimes 3 months, in other case, 3 years, okay? But this is not worth time. It's time to research. Because maybe research is a state of mind. If you are in research, you are with open eyes, open hair. And this is important. I need to try to find this, okay? I spent 3 years of my life. But in the path, I meet some stuff, no? Some other stuff. Similar, different, it's not this, it's like this. And my knowledge involved. If I go on the web and download in 3 minutes something about, I don't know, talking heads. I don't know nothing about talking heads. I know nothing about historical period. I know nothing about the cover. I know nothing about the credits. Why? Music is culture. Respect for the people that made this. Arts, non-arts, every opinion it's okay, but I think it's a serious position to take. My serious position is use vinyl. Yes, it's more comfortable go around for the world with a small bags with a lot of CDs. Sometimes DVDs. I saw in Ibiza a lot of DJs that comes with free DVDs. You're a DJ.
No, that's not really working,
sure.
Is it?
Sure, you are no records. Okay. But probably, I'm 40, and I'm from old school, okay, that's right. But I don't speak about the vinyl or CD or something else. I speak about the spirit of this job, nothing else. I think it's important that save the spirit around the possibility of technology give us. This is a remix by Chicken Lips that is go with a production like this now to a major. An A&R that is maybe 16, 18, older, not much, should be say to me, oh, that's 3-4 ideas for 3-4 records. This is the limit of modern music. The limit is the major attitude to say, to view in every sound, every different things, a possibility to gain. It's not. This is music, and that is not, is my opinion.
Well, I just wanted to ask you something about this record. I mean, obviously, disco influenced Italian music, but how much did Italian music have an effect on disco?
It's very strange by an Italian DJ speak about Italian music. It's very strange because we don't feel this scene like concrete things. It's all time from the beginning that I try to explain that my perception is a single experience by person. That's not a scene. Everybody does something without any relation with the world. Okay, just listening some records from USA, some records from UK, but without an in this moment. Okay, we are related through me and you. Probably somebody listened Gino Sosio, remains something in the air, and tomorrow comes some production by you, that is similar, with an idea, with a feeling derived by this record. And that is happening in Italy. We not never has been two persons that we must manage the way to do something. No. Very, very adventurously. Everybody produced his stuff with a in single way. With the, now it's changed because it's changed the media relation. I can publish my stuff on the web, and I can receive the feedback from all over. But until 10 years ago, there's nothing or similar.
Well, I think one of the things that's interesting about the disco period is the amount of second and third generation Italian Americans who were really important in the scene. Francis Grasso, Nicky Siano, David Mancuso. Is there something about being Italian that makes you predisposed to disco or to house or to this kind of music?
No.
And how come so many of those guys had an Italian background?
I don't think it's the same period. I think there's a delay of 4 or 5 years.
No, I mean, I definitely, but what I'm saying is those guys who started disco in New York, three of them had Italian backgrounds. How come?
I don't know.
I was hoping you could shed some light on it. I've always wondered about this. And no, you read a lot about these
sorry,
people.
But no, because
no one's ever solved this Italian disco mystery from a New York point of view.
Maybe my opinion about the research is true, because the research can put your goal everywhere. You start to find something, and you to looking for something, and you find another thing. I think that now Italian scene is interesting. And this is complex, because now it's changing everything, like all over in the world, everything about the technology, mm-hmm. That is the first thing. Now the technology is democratic. Mm-hmm. Everybody can do music without great expenses. And then everybody can publish is production sorry. Without a great...
Can I interrupt for a second?
Ah, sorry.
You said that technology is democratic, but what happens with the price of the machines that are different in US or maybe Eastern Europe or Africa or Australia? That's not the same.
I think you're right, I agree. But it's much better than in the past.
I think it's the same. It was the same.
Sorry?
This is the same in balance.
I don't think so. Because if you think that until 10 years ago, the only way to do music was go in a studio, $1,000, okay? Rent something, or pay musician. What's the occasion for a DJ to be producer? Just spend money, okay? Now, with a PC and a software like, I don't know, Live, or software like a Reason, you know? Very cheapest price. You do that. It's not so democratic like we can hope. Because tomorrow, I hope so, all over in the world it should be possible. No, I'm agreed. But think 10 years ago, 15 years ago. Dua Records, probably, I think, I remember in the 80s, Dua Records, Dua Mix, in Italy, costava around 10 million lire, around 5,000 euros, okay, in the 80s. One truck. Now, no, I think it's democratic because the concept of democracy is not political. It is about the possibility that you have to do music without any study, a particular study. I'm not a musician. I don't know any note. I don't know what is a pentagram. But I do music. This is democratic. I have in other historical period, I can do that.
I mean, I suppose there are some basic inequalities in the world that kind of any amount of cheap technology isn't going to solve. But I think it's, I guess your point is that now, if people want to make music in the kind of countries where it's possible to do that, then they can.
Exactly.
And that's a good thing.
Definitely, definitely.
But I wanted to ask you, you know, kind of you started DJing when you were 13, you know, you've done all these records, had all these hit records, you know, kind of become kind of very popular DJ, you know, people throw around figures saying, you know, like saying that you're a 10,000 euro DJ to book, all these things. Kind of what's next for you?
The next goal is my next gig ever. Because I think that that's a strange, a paranoid for everybody that do the DJ seriously. To follow the perfection of the set. The perfection don't exist, okay? Because there's too much variable things in a night. Humoral, emotional, and material things. And every time that I have a gig, I think the next time I'll do it better. The next time, don't finish. Never. And my wife is very disappointed about this because she's waited that I stop to go around. But my goal is follow my idea of a perfect DJ. Perfect DJ is a DJ that don't follow any pressure by the external secondary thing. Not from the money, not from the people, not from the media, but just from the feeling. It's a like Tibetan idea, okay? Really pure, really probably utopic idea, but I think if you choose a target, you must choose very high. And I try to do the best, my best.
So you're basically saying aspiring DJs of the world aim high.
No. I think, but I don't say this.
No, you're saying that the aim is to aim high.
Everybody, I think that every DJ in this zone say I'm the best of the world, and this is important because auto ricaricarsi. Oh, sorry.
So it's kind of a self-belief. It's good for you.
Auto charge is very important, no? But it's not so nice to tell.
Okay. Well, listen. Do you want to kind of finish up by playing us one more tune, maybe that sums up perhaps some of the reasons why you became DJ in the first place?
Yeah. With a greater pleasure, I want to play something that For me, it's very, very modern, because that's a lot of elements that Carl Craig... No, I love it, because it's a travel, a real travel. Travel of mind, a travel of ideas. It's like an adventure in a forest, you know? You start from I don't know, the high grass, and then forest, and then animals, and then I don't know what. And this is the right spirit of the dance music, because it's not only to dance, but it's good to listen. And I really appreciate that this is a work where I found that the roots of Carl Craig comes from Detroit too, you know. But Pepe Braddock from France, with probably African roots and Brazilian rhymes, everything. Yeah, great. It's great. Any question?
Yeah, that's right. Do you have any questions?
I'm so embarrassed.
Can you tell which label is that?
Sorry?
The label.
Ah, di questo? Questo era...
BNG.
Sì, BNG.
BNG.
BNG, bravo. It's from France. If you wanna... Se vuoi prenderti i credits... Ok, a posto. A parte i credits.
Okay, any other questions from around here?
Are you still producing music? You said you haven't produced anything for a while. Are you still with your label? Are you making music? What kind of music are you making at the moment? Like, I know this is up, you're a DJ,
yeah,
and you've been DJing, but you also say that you produce music,
yeah,
yourself?
I think that my job is to be DJ, and producing is my hobby.
Ah, okay. Do they feed off each other?
Sorry?
Do they feed off each other? One
yeah.
feeds the other?
The other, I open in the winter time. But it's so difficult, because at the moment in Italy, it's so difficult to find somebody that do the distribution of vinyl, records vinyl, of dance. Nobody wants
What is the market?
Stuff.
What is what is Italy looking for on the dance floor? You say they're not interested in dance records, but I think Italy, for me, is very interested in dance records.
Yeah, but there's not the structure, you know? The market in Italy is so few that nobody say to me, okay, I spend my money for your product, but if I want to spend my personal money for my product, it's not possible again, because I need to distribution my product in the world. In Italy, there's not a good situation.
Do you think there's enough DJs in Italy?
Sorry?
Do you think there's enough DJs in Italy?
No, there's a lot of DJs.
And do you
too
think
much?
Too many DJs. So do you think that really the problem is not the fact that we don't, the fact that there is not perhaps enough
record
stores?
No, it's a cultural problem. It's a cultural
solely
problem.
Cultural problem.
No, I think so. Because nobody... know the business to invest on the DJ music, okay? There was in Italy until a couple of years ago, UMM, somebody maybe remember, UMM or Media Records. There was the only labels, record labels, come from the dance that operated for the dance. And now are finished. Or some, because the market, the the rules of the rules of the market are the money. If you don't make money, you don't exist, simply. And this is the reason because I look in to the web like a resource, because it should be a great occasion for the music, for the dance music, for electronic music, because now the DJ is like a little media. The DJ is not like a musician. The DJ is important. This is so difficult to explain. I think that every DJ, everybody, is a little radio, okay? A radio station. Yeah, because I manage myself, I play myself, my music. But I am free and credible, okay? Because nobody pay for play this record or not, except some somebody in there. Okay, not in every case. And this this is a complex system, so different from the past. Okay. The major label and the system and the money system don't know like manage the state of things. And now the market is fall down, is fall out. Because it's completely new. There's no concert, there's no rock star. That's Fatboy Slim with 200,000 people. And this is a fact that changed completely the scene. The A&R behind the desk say, what fucking is happening now? Where I can put my money? On you, on you, on you? What? Everybody can do the next rock star. Everybody. In this confusion, the market is broken completely. But that's a great occasion for everybody. And this is my dream, because, sorry if I repeat myself, 10 years ago, just 10 years ago, no way, no possibility. Just for Frankie Knuckles in New York or I don't know, or Polo Conforti in London. But because this person was in a system of money that permit to them to do his project. Now everybody is the owner of his life, of his project, of his career. And so this is historical, completely new thing in the world of the music.
So we're just basically saying, bring it on being independent and bring it on doing it yourself.
Sorry, bring? Ah, sì, sì, sì.
Yeah.
Fai da te, sì. I think that it is, it's okay until a certain point, okay? Then you need somebody else. Because when the game is not a game but a great business, you need to save your soul. And to save your soul, you need some person that do other things. To leave the mind free to think only to the music. It's very hard. It's very hard. Because it's very hard to come from a place with a flight that is in delay, you arrive and the room in hotel is not ready, and then you go straight to the restaurant and then to the club, like a box, you know. But when you arrive behind the desk, you must ready to do your job, because your face, the face is yours. The people don't know that you are in delay with the flight. People know that you are Claudio Coccoluto. You must play the better set of your life and nothing else. And
well,
I do that.
That's an insight into the life and times of a DJ by Claudio Coccoluto. So thank you very much.
Oh, thank you.